Hey guys, Cloud Wolf here, and we're back today with another video of how to make an adventure map. This one is part 4, and today we're going to be doing a little more commanding, but mainly just more building and more detail stuff. So let's get right into it. So last time we added these commands, and we also added the teleport book, which we are going to use to go to the house right now. There we go. And we're going to follow the pathway, slash weather, clear. So now I'm going to fly my way down into the mine to get the exact coordinates, and also we're going to, one thing that I'm going to do is block off all the parts of the mine that are basically just lead the player away from the central story. So basically they should come across a dead end every time they go the wrong way, rather than coming back to the surface or something weird happening. So yeah, I'm going to work at that, and I'll get back to you guys. Okay, so we're back, and back to the cabin, and I made sure that all the pathways lead to basically nothing, and yeah, so they just end up in dead ends. So in the cabin, what I have planned to do is have this blood trail follow its way down the stairs, where there's going to be a bunch of dead bodies. So this kind of turned from an adventure map. Ish, whatever. I mean, it's still an adventure map. I think it's an adventure map, but it kind of turned into a horror map. So, sorry about that, guys, but I just felt like making a horror map, I guess. It's been a while. It's been, maybe 6, 7, 8, 9. It's almost been a year since I last made a horror map. The last horror map I made was in the 60-minute maps, which I'm going to try to compile those into one thing for you guys to play, because I know a lot of people don't actually play my 60-minute maps because they're not in a direct download slash video. So I'm going to be doing that pretty shortly here. It doesn't take me that long to put them into one world, but that will release, I guess, technically release, but I did make it a really long time ago. So anyways, that should come out sometime soon. If you guys really want it way sooner, I can just make it like pretty close to today if you want. I can just finish it up today if you guys really want it, but there's no rush for me really. But if you guys really want it soon, I can do it. Anyway, so I'm just basically working on making this a little bit more detailed, and I'll get back to you guys when it is done. Okay, so now we're back, and I added this little underground room. It took me a while because I did edit some entities to have this guy dead on the floor, his legs chopped off, hanging on the wall, and yeah, it's pretty crazy. And let's see. Nah, okay. So we got this dead guy in the basement, and then there's also this alternative room. So what we're going to do is work on some of the redstone now, or command blocks. We're going to have this, take this, the coordinates 12 to 39. Then let's get this coordinates. Right here. 44, and then we're going to use our book and go back to our redstone place right here. We're going to alter our book so that the mine has the coordinates. Where is it? Mine, and then run command TP. Here we go. Okay, so we're going to change this. Done. Delete our book. Get a new one. Now we can teleport to our mine. Okay. Then we're going to. Ooh, it's thundering. Nice, creepy. Okay. Then we're going to go back over to here. Eh. Get our stone. There we go. Carry that over. Copy this. Paste that. Copy that. And. Let's do radius of one. And put our commas. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're testing that the player is basically in the cabin. And yeah, so then we'll initiate the next text. Like so. Let's see. Does this say something? Yes, okay, it does. So now, here we go. Find these coordinates, negative 87, 47, 298, and teleport the armor stand here. So now I'm going to make some more text, and this one is going to have to do with when you get there, and then I'll be back. Okay, so I'm back, and now what I'm kind of doing is a little bit more detailed. I'm making it so when the player walks in, they walk in, the thunder strikes, and actually, I need to. Well, let me just change. I actually need to change this to be here. Nev 110, 12, well, 241. Okay, so it needs to be 241, that way they're all the way in the room. But once they go into the room, it'll detect they're here, and then it shoots the thunder, and they can't see it, they just hear it, and then they go blind. So we go back here, like so. Change this to 41. There we go. It starts a chat, they say something, they click it, and this is where the clicking text is useful because They click the chat, and then it does the thunder, so it makes sure they've read the chat first before it shoots the thunder. It's not on a timer, and then initiates the next chat, which tells you we should probably get out of here. And then it tells you this one, which is tip. Check the door, and the door will be locked. And how I'm going to do that is pretty simple. I'm just going to go back to the mine. Get a command block. Open up MC Stacker. Go down to the villager. It's right here. Tag this door. And make it invulnerable status effect. Invisibility 1 for a million seconds. Oh man, there's cars honking like crazy. I think it's really busy today. Anyway, so silent, give it no AI, and copy this. Give it offers, and here is one of my tips. Here's tip number one or whatever. When you summon any villager, make sure you add this tag that's offers, colon, bracket, bracket, comma. And that'll just make it so that their trade is nothing. And this is very useful for any kind of thing. If you want to make a map where people talk, where the villagers talk to each other, you need to do that. If you want to make a map where you have the pretty much anything that has a right-click event is useful for if you do. Dang it. Okay. It's useful to have villagers with the offers, and then you create a scoreboard that is talk. And I'll do that in a moment, real quickly. Okay, so that's actually fine. So to make the door locked, there's a couple things that I'm going to do. I have this right-click detection, which I'm going to bring him forward a little bit more. Where did he go? He is directly in the doorway now. There we go. Okay. Now he's directly in the doorway. Okay, so for the most part, you should be able to open it, correct? Ah, that's my issue. There's a, the no collision rule. Okay, so to fix this, what we're gonna do is scoreboard teams add generals, scoreboard teams options, general collision rule false. Never. And join the door to general, and then we're going to join me to general. And now we should not have that problem. Demo 3, see where he is. Should be 0.5. There we go. Okay, you can still open the door. So let's just make it right in front of the door. Okay. You can still kind of open the door, but you'll, for the most part, right-click on him. Then let's take the exact coordinates here, F3. Negative 109, 0.6, 12, 240. Copy that, paste it into here. So we have our command going. Then we're going to go back to the redstone. Go over here. Put a repeater. Summon him like so. Then also in addition, go here and summon the slime. And then also we are going to give ourselves a command block That's like this. Repeat, always active, and we're going to put the team thing that we did here. And then we're going to also do the player one. Okay, so we're back, and I just had to really quickly reopen my Minecraft because the size was all screwed up. Anyway, so we have the villager. He gets summoned there, so they right-click it. Then we also have to create over here. We have to create a slime to lock the door, which is so that players can't open it. So we're going to go to slime. We're going to call it lock. And we're going to give it a size of 1 and make it silent, no AI, invulnerable, status effects, invisibility, 1000000. Oh, and then you have to also add an entity, which is also slime, so basically a stack, and make it size of 1, call it lock, silent, no AI, same up here, yeah. Invulnerable, status effect, invisibility, 1 for a million seconds. Okay, then let me just go back to the mine. And let's try summoning it in. And where was this? 3. -1, 10, 12, 2, 39. There we go. Now let's power it. There we go. Okay, so now let's see if we can open this. Okay, so we can open it at the top, so what I'm going to do is change the size, because I haven't done this in a while, change the size to 2. Then we should be able to open the lock. Okay, so now let's try this again. Scoreboard teams join, general. Okay, now we can't open it well. Okay, yeah, we can't open it at all. Yeah, okay. And then we also have to take note, so we'll copy and paste this. Oh, back into the world. Copied it. Let's go to the redstone. Set this down here. And let's also put... Actually... Sorry, guys. This is where I start to kind of blank out because I'm thinking about like what to do for the map. And it gets... kind of complicated because I'm kind of making things up as I go, and things get distracting. So actually, I'm going to move this over here, and because of the method I'm using, players can just exit out of the chat sequence and not click next, so I got to put it before it gets to the tip, okay? And now I'm going to also have to put one more command block, which sets that block to the spruce door. So slash set block, block. Set block door, spruce underscore door. Okay. Let's go to the mine and basically try to duplicate this door but shut. So spruce door, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is spruce door of 6. Okay. So let's set block 1, 10, 12, 244. 239. That is the wrong one. It is 4. Okay. So now, when I try as hard as I can't open the door. Works out. And I'll make it so when it right clicks on the villager, it'll say something interesting. Okay. So now let's go to redstone and copy and paste that in too. Then we're going to use the scoreboard objectives add talk stat dot talk traded with villager. Talked, not traded. Talk to villager. And this is very useful for stuff like this, where you detect right-click detection for a specific point. Okay, and I don't actually need that right now. Okay. So now, again, we're going to use this thing, and we're going to, this time, do slash execute at e tag equals door, so executing at that, and then slash test for at a with score underscore talk underscore min equals 1 comma race equals 5. So basically just detecting if somebody right clicked on him. And then like so. Then if it does, it'll teleport the text like every other one of these to advance in the sequence. And it's going to go to 3. There we go. Right here. Negative 87, 47. 285. So yeah, so this is getting pretty detailed in terms of how specific things are getting. I mean, they're testing if the door is unlocked or not, and it's not. I mean, it's not unlocked, but it is locked. Yeah. Okay. Then put a pressure plate, and I'm going to add some more chat now. Okay, so now we're back at the redstone, and I'm going to probably conclude this episode right when I get past this small point, which is when there's the dead guy in the basement and you come across him. So I'm going to follow this pathway. Copy this here. Yeah, not that one. I want to copy this. There we go. And copy these coordinates of the dead guy. Get the radius increased. Put commas. Boom. Okay. Now we're good. So, you're by the dead guy's body. Then it's going to put the set block right there. And teleport the chat yet again. This time over here. And I'm going to space it. Well, I can just put it like this and make it skip over. Never know how long it's going to be. Okay, so there's not as many tips this episode, guys. Sorry about that. But it's mainly just me working on some stuff. And I guess the tips you can get out of it are the different strategies I use to test for players in certain places and detect certain things happening. But this is more kind of on the detailed side, but I did say that I would record every episode that I would record everything that I do on the camera, so that is what it's going to be, and a lot of fast-forwarding, sadly. But anyway, so go to the door, there's your tip. Okay, so that's where I'm going to end it for today, guys. Got a lot of stuff done. We're further in the story. Now we have finished. We've caught up to all our builds, and now we're probably going to have to do more building next episode, and probably a lot more tips for how to build things, because there is some specific things you have to do. But other than that, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you all later.